episode live from Moodyville. Thanks so much for joining, and today we got a great guest. Looking forward to bringing you so many things that might interest you, some words of inspiration, but also funny stories. So please continue to listen to Live from Moodyville.
All right, folks, I got my main man, Chuck Cherry.
What up?
All right, Chuck, you got to be in the screen, Chuck, so they can see you. Hey, now slide over. All right, folks, we're experimenting now. We're trying to do a... Yeah, we're trying to do the video and use the box at the same time. Chuck is about to get out of here. We've had a great trip. He's spent a couple of weeks up here in Moodyville working on a new book. Yeah. And, folks, it's great to be with my old roommate. 46 years we've been knowing each other. In fact, we were laughing the other day. I went and sat on the bed while he was sitting there on the bed. I went and sat there, and we were talking. I started laughing. I went, boy, this reminds me of college when we would have those bunk beds and sit there and be talking and telling stories. And here we are, 64, still telling the story. So, Chuck, what's up, man?
Hey, man. Things are great. You know, I'm just glad to put these sore feet on the ground. Hallelujah.
I know what you mean, man, because I tell you. In the morning. Yes, because, Chuck, it's something right now, man. Being an entrepreneur, I was just thinking the other day, it really hit me. 32 years of making payroll, man. If anybody's been an entrepreneur, you understand what I'm talking about. 32 years of making payroll and never missing a payroll and never shorting a check. But it definitely has worn on me, and it's time for me to do a reset because I'm actually just a little tired. I'm just emotionally tired.
Yeah, I get it, man. And people who are not entrepreneurs don't understand that when you have to essentially take care of the baby, which is the business first, and then you have to, I remember when I was practicing law and I had a secretary, just she and I, when I first got started, there were some days, and I paid her on a weekly basis every Friday. There were some days, man, where I did not have the money to pay her on a Friday, but praise the Lord, somebody came in to get a $50 consultation and they paid cash. And I didn't even have time to go to the bank to deposit it. So I just gave her cash. And because I knew that as an entrepreneur, you cannot short your help. You can't do that.
Yeah, you know, because once you miss a paycheck, they're gone.
Now it's done deal.
Yeah, done even deal. If they don't leave, they're looking because they know, uh-oh, this is getting shaky.
Yeah. So, man, so I have to congratulate you on that, because when I think about how many weeks that's like 2,000. If you did a weekly payroll, that's like 2,000, 2,500 weekly payrolls that you have made on a consistent basis. And then as your business grew, I mean, I'm just the numbers, man.
I just
man.
Didn't realize the cost. Now, I wouldn't trade what I've done, but I wish I didn't need to know how much I was going to give up. I mean, but
sometimes if you know, you're not going to do it.
Yeah, and that's the thing. Why I think it was great the way I went in business. We were broke.
Yeah.
I was young. Didn't have nothing really to lose but whatever we had borrowed. But, yeah, it's probably better not to know what it really requires of you, because there are times I would be walking the floor at 4:30 in the morning, and I'll never forget the time that I said, okay, this is getting crazy. I was pacing the floor. We had been in business probably 3 years or so. I was pacing the floor, worrying about how we're going to make it, you know, the next job. Because when you eat what you kill, you know, which is what we say in our industry, because you're always on the hunt trying to look for the next project. When I finish a building project, that might be the only building that client ever builds. Mm-hmm. So you're always on the hunt and you're trying to get backlog. But I'll never forget this. I had two little kids. They're sleeping upstairs in the room, you know, little babies. My wife is sleeping. And I got up at 4:30, and I just started pacing, and then I went jogging. Then all of a sudden, it hit me. I'm like,
wait a minute, hold up. You jogging
that's what I'm going to tell you. So all of a sudden, it hit me. It's pitch black. Pitch black outside, and I'm jogging. And all of a sudden, I'm like, fool, what are you doing running at 4:35 in the morning through your neighborhood in the dark? And when I got home, I said, okay, I got to figure out a better way.